You're watching the Red Zone Sports Show on Fox 5.
We need everyone here to hunker in and to be committed to the process, because the process is what gets us the result.
Straight ahead in the Red Zone, the Rebels make it rain at the Spring Showcase, showing off the talent before Mother Nature intervened. Tony Sanchez is in studio to break his team down as spring practice wraps up. Plus, the Rebels storm the weight room. We take you inside the off-season strength and conditioning program that will pay dividends in the fall. And
that's where we want to be. We want to play on the last Monday. And we'll put all our work towards that beginning immediately.
A sit-down one-on-one with Chris Beard, what the 12th full-time Runnin Rebels head coach in history has to say about his plan to bring UNLV back to prominence. It's the final Reb Zone of the season, and we wanted a stylish way to say that's a wrap.
What you talking about, Tom? You blind? You got Ray fans? You see, I took your girl and now she my number one fan.
Coach Sanchez says he might even bust a rhyme.
I'm just kidding.
The Reb Zone, working to unite the Rebel family right now.
This is the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
Good evening. Welcome inside this special spring football edition of the Reb Zone. Thanks for joining us, Kevin Bolinger, alongside UNLV head football coach Tony Sanchez. No rapping today?
No rapping today. We're good. I'm gonna save that.
let's talk some football. Spring practice is over, and I know you walk away pretty happy with what you're seeing.
Yeah, you know, I mean, really, when you look at the entire body of work, the entire 15, you know, opportunities we had to go out there, we made a lot of progress. You know, we had a lot of, I keep talking about competitive depth. We saw that, saw the guys really dig in and fight. And it's a good group that, you know, and they understand the processes. You know, year two is always better. They understand the expectations, the way we need to practice, attention to detail, just the accountability, watching film and getting better every day. We saw that.
Let's start looking at the spring game. Mother Nature turned out to be one of the stars of the Rebels Spring Showcase as it shortened the game to just one half. But we did get a good look at where UNLV is at spring practice wrapped up.
A big crowd and a lot of buzz as the Rebels took the field for the spring game. Johnny Stanton was up first at quarterback with his unit, and on the option, he pitched to David Green for a nice gain around the left end. Stanton also went aerial as he connected with Devontae Boyd. The JC transfer finishing 3 of 7 for 54 yards. The defense had its moments as well. Watch Anthony Zepeda break up the pass. And the big hit by Gabe McCoy to stuff the play. Kurt Palandek showed off his running skills when he was in a QB, rushing up the middle and popping outside before the play was blown dead as the quarterbacks were not able to be hit. Running back Lexington Thomas was impressive, not only with the burst of speed, but watch him keep his feet and get extra yardage. The quarterbacks alternated possessions. Stanton with the quick hitter to Brandon Presley, and he moved inside the 10 before that drive stalled. Palandek answered, going to Boyd for 12 yards and a first down. Then he's flushed out of the pocket, and he's able to scramble. The only touchdown of the game came as Palandek found tight end Trevor Campbell, who makes a great grab for the score. Then the rains came in buckets, scattering the crowd. It was followed by lightning, which forced the team to leave the field. At that point, the game was called. Not the ideal situation, but Coach Sanchez told his team afterwards he was happy with how spring camp went.
We're a better football team. God, we're a year more forward than we were last year, right? And the understanding of what you need to do every single day to win is evident. You got to continue to work forward. I mean, you saw that crowd out today. I mean, there's so many people that are excited about you guys and where you're going and how hard you're working for this town and this community.
I know you only had a little bit of time yesterday because of the rain, but your general impressions of the spring game that you saw yesterday?
It was good. You know, I mean, it was great to see all the fans out there. That's a big thing, you know, to get out there and get our kids engaged with them and vice versa. You know, wish we would have had that time with them afterwards. But it was great to see that great atmosphere. And our guys were ready to go. I mean, they came in and had a real workmanlike approach to the day. And, you know, we had some good meetings beforehand, watching film. And they came out and in a very short amount of time executed some good things. And, you know, it's great to see new guys like Trevor Kahneman make plays like that. You know, Lexington just continuing to evolve. I mean, he's still only going into a sophomore year. And then young guys like Brandon Presley stepping up and making plays. And Johnny Stanton and Kurt both showing up and playing well. And, you know, defensive side of the ball, Evan Ostry, a guy that we redshirted last year. Gabe McCoy, you showed a highlight film with him, another guy we redshirted. So there's a lot of young guys out there that, you know, are going to step up and make a big difference along with the newcomers.
There is competition at all positions, and certainly there was really no separation at the quarterback position as you guys move towards getting into to camp in August.
Yeah, you know, I mean, again, we're looking at a bigger body of work than just one game, you know, and we saw some good things. You know, you look at Johnny, he actually threw a really good ball into the end zone. I went and watched it earlier. You know, we had a drop ball right there, so he made a good play there. And he got us into some good checks, and, you know, and Kurt did well, too. So, yeah, you know, there's a little separation, but it's smaller than you might think.
In practices throughout the last month, it seemed like the defense certainly stepped up and maybe shined a little bit more. You have to be happy with the progress that they've made over the last year and a half, and they seem to kind of have a little bit of an advantage going into the summer.
No doubt. You know, I mean, one of the biggest areas you saw improvement on was the defensive line. They really did a good job. Again, it's an older group. They're doing better. You know, some of those guys we redshirted stepped up and did well. Coach Samuels did a really good job of tightening that group up. And, you know, schematically, a couple little different wrinkles here and there that fit our personnel a little bit better. So Coach Bear, I mean, he's a tremendous defensive coordinator, and they're going to be a good unit this year.
Comfort level with this team as you end spring practice?
It's good. I'm proud of our guys. I mean, they're a hard-working group of guys. They got a blue-collar mentality to them. They understand the physicality it takes to win at this level, and they're understanding that it's a year-round process, and they're buying into it. So we're going to push them hard, and then they're going to eat it up.
With that in mind, we are just getting started in the Reb Zone, and up next, we have an in-depth look at the Rebel football strength and conditioning program. We're going to show you how things are different this year and how they're having a little fun with some rap battles. Don't want to miss this one. It's coming up in 2 minutes as the Reb Zone rolls on.
This hair-raising play of the week is brought to you by Vegas Valley Hair.
At the Rebel Spring Showcase, Kurt Palandek in the red zone, and he slings the bullet to Trevor Kahneman, who makes the great grab for the touchdown. It's the hair-raising play of the week.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
Now that spring practice is over, a lot of the work will be done in the weight room. The Rebel football program is in good hands with Keith Belton, who is making sure that it's time well spent.
Storming the weight room, this is the new attitude of Rebel football. Off-season training has been met with energy, purpose, and results.
The honeymoon's over.
Strength and conditioning coach Keith Belton is whipping this team into shape to get them ready for the fall.
Good job, good job.
This place ain't for everybody. This is not a rest haven. We're here to be productive and to win the football games.
The transition year is over. The weight room has become an office. This isn't a 9-to-5 job, and the players are being held accountable.
You don't want to work, you don't really have the option to go somewhere else. You just won't lift at that time. What we'll do, you just come lift with me early that morning. So you won't lift at your lifting time. You just come early in the morning. We just do a one-on-one session until we get all that sweetness out of you, and then you come back and you be ready to work with the team.
And while Belton oversees it all, the jury is the peers. Because your teammates know if you're not putting in the work.
When you turn the music off and you see guys sweating, you see them about to cry, you see them running until they're about to throw up at times, and then you see the teammates run on across the field and go pick up their teammate and encourage them. I love that because that's when you build a team.
Finish on the stretch! Finish on the stretch! Ready! Stretch!
Ooh!
That's a good one. The best one in the whole year. I think the TV need to be out here every single day because somehow y'all decide you're going to do it right.
Whether it's on the field.
Go get him. Go get him.
Or in the weight room.
Keep going, Mark. Keep going, Mark. Keep going, Mark. Great job.
You can see and hear a winning team emerge.
I love the nitty and gritty. We did things a lot different this spring compared to how we did it last year when we first got here. We turned the music off. We went back to military style. We did everything on cadence.
Up! Down!
One.
Up! Down!
Two.
So the level of productivity was there. The accountability was there because there was nowhere to hide. And the people who couldn't do it, they got exposed in front of the whole team.
Fans will see a noticeable difference in a lot of the players, and that will lead to a team that doesn't get as many injuries and will finish games in the fourth quarter.
They're putting the weight on, but we're doing it the right way. We're not trying to do it all at once, but by the time September comes, we'll be where we need to be. Guys will be bigger, they'll be stronger, they'll be faster, they'll be able to move a little better.
Stand right down your butt, take your right leg, put it over your left leg, put your knee to your chest.
Yoga has been incorporated into workouts, and with a training table added into the program, nutrition and diet is monitored to get maximum results.
The biggest thing as far as the guys getting bigger, we have full-fledged breakfasts in here every single morning, and that's something we didn't have last year. We were just fixing peanut butter jelly sandwiches, hoping the guys could go to the dining commons to get some food, but now we feed the guys every single day, burritos and pancakes and sausages and eggs and grits and oatmeals, so they get that every single day, so there's no excuses not to get big and get stronger now.
Hey, I'm gonna make a deal with you.
But the time with Belton isn't just about strength and conditioning, it's building a bond that is just as important. That means daily battles.
Compete, 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 compete.
Not only on running drills and weights, but some fun competition as well, like the rap battles. Some good.
What you talk about, Tom, you blind, you got rave fans? You see, I took your girl and now she my number one fan. Me, I'm holding the chrome. Me, I'm up in your zone. Keep talking in that chopper, break all of your bones. Ride talk, I'm talking about a chopper. Hold on, dang it, hit his head and turn his head to some pasta. Dreads wrapped up, I'm kind of looking like Flocka. Chopper hit his body and put his body in doctors.
First off, don't talk about the DBs. Because you, we all know you want to be just like me.
Yeah.
And let's talk about the stats, because you can't score. When we try to get a touchdown, they count on 13 and 4.
And some that need work.
Yeah, you make fun of me for being from the North. I ain't ever rapped before.
But I still want the floor.
Rebel football has become a family, a unit that is bonded. People you bleed for, you encourage, and you push to achieve. For the next few months, the family home is the weight room. This fall, it will be moving day. The home moves to the field. But wherever you live, the family stays together.
Brothers on me, brothers on three. One, two, three.
Brothers.
All right, let's just start with the rap battles.
Yeah.
Talented, obviously. Devontae Boyd, obviously very talented. But that bonding experience, you can see the guys buy into it. That's, you know, priceless.
One of the neatest things about college football is you got a bunch of young men, great young men that come from a lot of different places. And when they come here, this has got to be home. So, you know, there's going to be some tough days, and there's always going to be the seriousness. But you can't take yourself too serious, you know what I mean? At times, you know it's laughter and, you know, smiling and feeling good about it. That's a great antidote to turn things around and to get people to fight hard. Because at the end of the day, if you love each other, you're going to play harder for each other. And I've always believed that. You know, to me, the game is built on relationships. And if you can build relationships with your coaches, with your teammates, with all the personnel within the building, and everybody's driving in the right direction, you got a great chance for success. So Coach Belton does a great job of, you know, working those guys, but also making sure that they're having fun and enjoying the process and they're caring about each other.
When it's time to go to work, though, these guys have been going to work. You can see it on the field. You can see it in the weight room. Is there a certain focus that you're giving a directive to Coach Belton in terms of what you want this team to accomplish here in the offseason workouts?
No doubt. I mean, that was part of the interview process when I brought him in. That's, you know, something that we talk about weekly. We talk about it in staff meetings. I mean, there are standards that we have to set. You know, so that's fun. It's fun to laugh and, you know, rap and do all the cool stuff. But you got to work. I mean, you got to earn the right to do that stuff, you know. Hey, you want to go out and, you know, have a nice meal, he better earn the right to get a paycheck to pay for that, right? And that's what those guys are doing. And they're busting their tail, and he understands that, you know, this whole thing's about toughness. We've got to become a tougher organization, and if we can do that, keep holding ourselves accountable, we do a great job of recruiting, adding talent into that group, then you know what, we're going to win football games, and you know, we're going to win a Mountain West championship, and you know, consistently go to bowl games. You know, that's the formula, and that's what we got to get done.
Well, Coach Sanchez, not the new kid on the block on campus anymore. There is a new coach on campus. Up next, we're sitting down to go one-on-one with Runnin Rebels head coach Chris Beard to go in depth on the past and the future That's next as the Red Zone rolls on.
You're watching the Fox 5 Red Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
Welcome back inside the Rev Zone. We're joined now by new Runnin Rebels head coach Chris Beard. Coach, welcome to town after what's been a roller coaster couple of weeks here to get things rolling.
Thank you. Excited to be here.
What? Tell us a little bit about why UNLV. Why was this job attractive to you when I'm sure you were, you know, going to have some options with other jobs out there as well?
Yeah, that's easy. I mean, this is one of the most historical programs in the history of college basketball. You know, I remember as a kid growing up, I'd never been to Las Vegas and never been to the university, but when I thought of UNLV, I thought Runnin Rebel basketball. You know, as a coach, you always ask yourself, has it been done there before? And it has been done here at the highest level. So we have a great city, a great university, great people, tradition, facilities. I just think it's a place where you can win at the highest level.
For fans wanting to know what kind of style of basketball, we know you're defensive minded. People are sitting there wondering about the offensive minded thing with the Runnin Rebel side. What kind of basketball are people going to see when they come to the Thomas and Mack?
Yeah, above all, winning basketball. You know, we try to recruit the best players we can and put them in a situation to win each game on the schedule. Certainly on offense, we like to play in a way that our players have freedom and they space the floor and can use their individual talents. There's things we believe in like unselfishness and the extra pass and advancing the ball. And then we're totally committed to the defensive end of the floor. This year at Little Rock, we had one of the best defensive teams in college basketball, and that'll be the backbone of our teams here, you know, defensively, and then just really good offensive players having the freedom to play.
We go back to the slap the floor type of defense that I think fans like to see. Speaking of slapping things, we still have the injured hand. I think that actually intrigues, and a lot of people like the fact that you're willing to do what it takes to motivate your team, turning a 5-point halftime deficit when this happened to a 20-point win.
Yeah, I need to work on my boxing skills, that's for sure. But no, I'm a passionate guy, I'm an intense guy, but above all, I'm a player's coach, got a great relationship with our players. You know, great players want to be coached. Great players want discipline. Great players want to be pushed. I've just got to learn how to throw a punch without breaking my hand. But the intensity and the fire will always be there if it's to help our guys.
Speaking of players, you obviously have some roster spots that you have to fill and are getting a little late start on recruiting with a signing day coming up. How do you and your staff now go out and try and get guys here that can play immediately?
Well, first it's just we have a standard of excellence. And I'm not really concerned with what we don't have or how much time we don't have. I'm concerned with what we do have, and what we have is an opportunity here. Certainly, we're going to have to work really hard, quickly, in recruiting. We've got some good players on this year's roster that we're hopeful that will come back. We're in the process right now of identifying that. And then we definitely need to get out there in recruiting to add some players to these guys we have. But there's different venues, whether it be junior college or transfers or high school players that are unsigned around the country. I promise you we're going to look anywhere and everywhere as hard as we can to try to put together the kind of roster that we could all be proud of next year.
I know one concern that fans had was the fact that as you've moved up the ladder, as coaches do in every sport, you have had to move about every year or so, sometimes a two-year spot. How do you assure fans that this isn't just a quick stop for you to be going up the ladder even further?
Yeah, well, that's a fair question, but I mean, UNLV is a destination. It's not a stop. This is one of the best basketball jobs in the country and a great city. And so I think above all, what my experience has been is winning. That's what we hope to do here. But no, this is a place that's special. This is a place where you can play on the last Monday of the season. We've got a long ways to go to get there and a lot of work, but we embrace that challenge and head on. That's where we want to be. We want to play on the last Monday, and we'll put all our work towards that beginning immediately.
Ready to get to work and get it going?
Already have started working, but ready to work some more.
All right, Coach Chris Beard here at UNLV. We'll be hearing more from him when we get the Rev Zone going back at the start of the basketball season as well. For now, we're going to take a short break. We're back with Coach Sanchez and the Spring Football Plays of the Week right after this.
You're watching the Fox 5 Rev Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
College football is a 12-month-a-year thing, and August can't get here fast enough, I'm sure.
No, it's, you know, now we go into that recruiting process. You know, the coaches will get out, hit the road. You know, I'll still be hunkered down with the guys and Coach Belton, make sure, you know, we're attacking that weight room. But it's going to be here before you know it, you know. So we're excited. It's going to be a great year. And, you know, we need our fans to get out there and make sure they get their season tickets. And we need you guys supporting us.
Yeah, season tickets, and the season has some very attractive home games, some very winnable home games on this schedule. This team has high expectations going into the fall of being able to do some good things.
It does, you know, and obviously we're trying to change that culture and kind of flip the script on the history of UNLV football. You know, I mean, we've never been able to consistently win over a long period of time, and, you know, we got to start approaching that and doing that. So we're excited about the schedule. I don't think there's any gimmies on it, but we definitely have high expectations, and, you know, we want to see ourselves playing week 13. And I told our guys, hey, you know what, you know, the first 12 games, they're scheduled. You want 13, go earn it, right? So we got to bust our tails and get out there and earn that 13th opportunity.
We are looking forward to it. Season tickets on sale right now at UNLVtickets.com. All eyes now do, of course, turn to the fall. Practices will resume in August to prepare for the season opener. That's against Jackson State at Sam Boyd Stadium on September 1st. That's a Thursday night. The Red Zone will return with a preview of the 2016 football season coming up on Sunday, August 28th. Of course, we look forward to seeing you then. Thank you so much for being a part of this season. Coach, thank you for all your help, as always.
Absolutely.
We've had a fun spring, and we look forward to the fall. And we're leaving you tonight with some of the top sights and sounds from the spring showcase on a rainy Saturday out at the soccer field. Good night.
We live in an unbelievable community that is so thirsty for us to get it going.
Won't you follow me into the jungle?
Zone Sports Show was presented by RC Willie, your home, your